He came back on Saturday 11, back from Shanghai, from the business trip. And he said to me, well, Dad, I assume it will be better that I will have a direct flight from Shanghai to Bali, to Singapore. I said, you sure? Don't you want to go together from Amsterdam? Well, at the end, he decided to go from Amsterdam. So he came in on the 11th of July, and on the 12th, I had my birthday. I became 70 years old at that moment, so I'm very happy. I can say we had a birthday party on Sunday the 12th. And they will depart from Amsterdam. The other family brought them to the Schiphol airport. And we had said, well, we pick you up and you'll come back 3 weeks later. And 3 weeks later, my wife had to keep me, to hold me, because I want to go to Schiphol to pick them up. Kijk, this is Remco, the youngest.
Remco.
That's his tea, his tree. That the joint investigation team will have so much evidence on the table that you can't deny it, that there can be person for being convicted in this case. So I do hope that the evidence is such a quality evidence, not one example, no, but 10, 12 or 15 examples of evidence, so the judge can make only one conclusion. I'm not interested in the pictures from the accused one.
This is my nephew, Robert, just 20 years old. Yeah. And there's the tree of a friend of Robert who went with them. He was just 17 years old. They wanted to go to Bali. And they had should have a stop in Kuala Lumpur, but they didn't get so far. I was having a drink with colleagues on the riverside in my village. And one of my colleagues looked at his smartwatch and said, hey, a plane crashed. And I asked them where it came from, from Amsterdam. Where did it go to? Kuala Lumpur. And at that moment I knew, because I knew my brother was going on holiday that day. You know, my brother never returned. There's nothing found of my brother. One of the two victims who isn't identified.
And, no baggage?
No baggage, nothing. As if he never existed. And of course I know he crashed over there. And possible his body is burned in the enormous fire. So that's the place where my brother is, in fact, is cremated, I think. It's the place where my brother and his wife and their son, where they died. So yeah, I was important that we get to know everything what's important. Who did it? Why did they do it? What happened exactly? Who was responsible? What was the role of Russia? And I think that's the most important to know. And you know, revenge. I can do nothing with revenge. The people who were responsible, they are. I said it. They are having a good time in Russia. But then I think not only for us, but also for the rest of the world, it's very important to know everything: who, why, what. And these answers we are waiting for.
MH70 was my last working day. Then my holiday would start in Holland Normal to take care of your kid, you know, 3 week long. So I was just home, 40 minutes. It was just busy. Flight was overbooked. So we were talking to many passengers, offering them an alternative routing. And it was good. And with the crew, I had many friends among the crew, waiting with them at the gate for the aircraft, showing them the photos of my newborn son.
To the crew of the plane.
Yeah, because I have many friends among them. And you know, we're a very small airline. Yeah, we're quite big in Malaysia, but it's just a fairly big family we all were. And that's why I come here to take care of them. And, and there was one last one who walked off the aircraft and closed the door. I got a call from our operations control center when I was home about 40, 45 minutes. Then I just heard that we lost contact with the aircraft above the Ukraine, and we first thought they were just, well, I had to close the station. I lost my job because of it. it had a huge impact on my life, and also the things, you know, I had my own staff on board and, with his wife and children. And so it's been a very painful period, but also I learned to live with it, learned to accept it, and build a new life with it. It's part of it, but it will always be part of my life, of course. Still, there is the care for the families sometimes. Close it for themselves. I think that's the most important. Families want closure. They want an explanation of why it happened. And hey, Dylan, hey, phenomenal, jongens.
Our son, Jack, was on MH17. We're from Sydney in Australia. He was on a trip. He was coming home. And he never made it.
We don't know, but what we know will happen and what's important happens is that all the evidence that's been accumulated that the investigators have put together over the last 5 years, that evidence is heard. For the first time that full range of evidence is spoken in court.
The truth is known, even if it's still denied, that it's gone through a proper court process and it's out there. What we expect, we know, like, our expectation is that the evidence is put out there and the decision is made and people know that.
And that people know who has been named and people know who is responsible.
Yeah.
And not just the immediate people, not just the four accused, if it turns out that they're guilty, but further on up the chain of command and lower down the chain of command.
25, he just like launched into adulthood. He had finished uni and was working. He studied business and sports management and was working in the fitness industry. And he was going on this trip, just 7 weeks around to raise, and quite sensitive. And then he grew into a confident young man.
Very strong, confident, strong opinions about things. Very strong on health and fitness. He loved football, like proper football. And he was coming home. He gave a message to someone he met overseas and he talked. We have thought about it.
We met with some of the Ukrainian community in Australia. Reached out to us, actually. And
we went to we've had conversations and meals with people from Ukraine. And we're conscious, too. There's so much attention on the people who were killed in the plane, 298 people, but we know at least 13,000 people have been killed on the ground in Ukraine, and we're conscious that the vast majority of those people are civilians, like our son, people who just wanted to go on with their lives and to live their lives normally, which is every person's right, changing very quickly.
We're not in control of that. We're here to be witnesses to a good and thorough court process, and we're here to represent Jack.